What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Jared, and we're continuing with this series of the top 10 best movies of this decade, 2010s, 2K10s, whatever the hell we're calling this decade. So the one that I did a couple days ago, depending on when I post this, was the top 10 comedies. Check that out up there. But then I'm like, what should the next video be? Top 10 romantic comedies? I love romantic comedies. Top 10 horror films? I don't watch horror films. So I was like, the movie genre that really blew up, it blew up a little bit before this decade, comic book movies. So we're gonna do the top 10 comic book movies of this decade. But before I get into my top 10 comic book movies, let me know what your guys' top 10 comic book movies, some that people should really go out of their way and check out. I mean, not just MCU movies, but there are a lot of other comic book movies that have come out in this 10-year span. So drop those down below. Anyways, though, let's get into some honorable mentions before I get into my top 10. And I would say honorable mention wise, we would got, let's see here. We have Logan. That was a very, you know, stripped down R-rated. Hugh Jackman is amazing in that film. Very much. That one was probably number 11 on my list. Guardians of the Galaxy. You know, switching it up, taking the MCU to a cosmic realm, and it was very, very fun. I'm trying to think of what else. Oh, Alita Battle Angel. I don't know if that's technically a comic book. It's more of a manga and anime and whatnot. Not actually, not even an anime, but overall not a great movie, but there's some great, the action in that and the main actress, I can't think of what her name is, I'll put it right here, phenomenal in that movie. And I hope that that movie kind of gets a sequel. Otherwise, I'm trying to think MCU wise, I can't think of anything that really pops out and really jumps onto my honorable mentions. So yeah, those are my honorable mentions. Let's get into number 10. So number 10 is going to be X-Men Days of Future Past. And this one and Logan, I didn't know which one to throw in there, but I think that this one had so much more unique and intriguing ideas in it. It very much took the older X-Men, the rebooted X-Men, put them together. They actually meet, they're in the same movie for the first time, and Logan having to go back to the past and dealing with all of these different ideas to essentially save the mutants. And then obviously at the very end, if you've seen this movie, the switch up, how he's the only one that remembers everything. And I think everything that they did with the characters, very much Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, was probably the best aside from Logan. I think that those two are very much toss-ups, but this is more of an ensemble movie, and I think I just like how they combined everything and just the ideas that they had in this film. Hitting at number 9 is sort of a switch up, you know, PG-13. This one is going to be Kick-Ass. And this is, I think, one of the first R-rated comic book movies. And I didn't even know that it was based on a comic book the first few times that I watched it. But Aaron Johnson in this, Chloe Grace Moretz as Kick-Ass, Hit Girl. This movie is f***ing brutal. I can't say f***ing. Oh, okay, this movie was f***ing brutal, but the action is great. It's very much raw. Like, this is a raw movie, and it's almost like street level. Like, these people in this world do not have superpowers, so it's not a superhero movie really. It's more of a comic book movie, and it's gritty, it's real, it's based essentially in real life. I mean, there's comedic, almost dark comedy aspects and characters that are over the top in this movie. But Kick-Ass is a great one to really go back to and check out, because I think it almost set the tone for other— oh, jeez, I hit the mic. I think it almost set the tone for other things moving forward, because this was 2010. So yeah, Kick-Ass and kind of everything that they put into this movie is great, because I think I haven't checked out the comic book, but you know, what they did in the movie is fantastic. Hitting at number 8 is going to be Dread. And I know that this one isn't probably going to be on everyone's top 10 list, because this, it wasn't essentially a big blockbuster movie. It's, I think I saw it later on, years later, you know, on a Blu-ray or a DVD, but it's almost, you know, a smaller movie. It takes place in one building. People have said, I haven't seen The Raid, but people are saying it's essentially the plot points of Raid, where this person goes into this building and has to get to the top. And I like that simple plot in this movie, but Carl Urban's character, him committing to the essentially role, or how the character never takes his helmet off and he has to act with just this part of his face, and I think he does a phenomenal job. I mean, he's this one, I wouldn't say one note character, but he's very tough, he's monotone, but he has a lot, he's a complex character, and I think that I like that to it. But also the technical side of this film with the slow-mo drug, and then I'm almost think I watched this in 3D one time or whatnot, but the 3D slow motion of the slow-mo drug in this movie combined with the action or what's happening around them is one of the coolest aspects in this movie. And I think I like it because, again, it's grittier, it's R-rated. Carl Urban is phenomenal as Dredd. So I think that this definitely should be on top 10 of this decade. Now we're getting into some that may cause some sort of controversy, but I think at number 7 is going to be Avengers Endgame. And I think that the reason it's hitting, you know, some people are going to say too low on this list is because it's recent. You know, if this one sits with me for a few more years, it might move up in my book. But the reason it is hitting on this top 10 is because what they did in this movie, this 3 hour plus epic movie, they took 22 movies, somehow jammed all that crap together, and it worked into this very satisfying conclusion. I think the reason, because we had never seen this before. We've seen trilogies, a few other things, but they haven't been as critically and acclaimed by audiences this high. But so many characters juggling everything, the technical aspects, this is a beautiful film. It's a phenomenal film. This is an event film. I mean, if you dive into some of the plot points of it, maybe some things don't entirely add up. Like, the real hero of the movie is a rat. He brings Ant-Man back, whatever. But aside from that, this is very much a spectacle film, and the feat, the technical feat, the just getting all of these people together for this movie is insane. So it is one of the top 10 of this decade. Now hitting at number 6, I think is the better of these films, is the original 2012 Avengers film. This one is essentially, you know, you're taking a smaller cast, you're getting them together, but this is the first time that we essentially got these characters together from all of their individual movies, jam them together into this movie, and this pretty much set up the MCU. I didn't know what the hell was going on with these Avengers movies. I didn't realize that all of this stuff was connected. And also, I think that this movie really got everyone started on board for the other 15 or so movies that came after Avengers, the 2012 version, because I was a casual fan at that time. I didn't know that these movies were connected. Found out that they were connected. Now I'm a huge fan and I watch all of the movies. So I think that this was almost a pivotal movie for not only the comic book genre, but the MCU in general and the future of the MCU. And, you know, it juggles the characters very well. It develops them a bit more, and it teaches them how to work as a team. And I mean, that end battle in New York is phenomenal. Hitting at number 5 is going to be Captain America Winter Soldier. I know that some people are going to say that Avengers and Endgame are way better than this movie, but this is a personal taste for myself. And I've always, every ranking list and throughout all of these Marvel movies, I still think that Winter Soldier is one of the best, if not, and actually I think it is the best MCU movie because it dives into almost a genre bend. You know, you have the superhero comic book movie, but this one leans into more of a political thriller and diving into essentially, you know, things in the MCU might not be what they seem. And I love how Captain America and Black Widow have to go almost undercover and do this research. And it, like I said, it's a political thriller, sort of a mystery, sort of a bromance as well, because we get Bucky the Winter Soldier in there. And the elevator scene, there's a lot of scenes in this movie, but the elevator scene specifically, the tension before the cool action and just badass fight choreography with all of the different dudes in this movie is awesome. I'm not saying that it's, you know, the finale is going to stick the landing like some of the other MCU movies, but I still think that the overall what is done in this movie deserves its spot higher than those other MCU films. Hitting at number 4 is going to be one that was also on my favorite comedies, and that's going to be Deadpool. And obviously this starts off as a comic book movie, a superhero movie. It also has touches of a romantic comedy, a romance movie, very much a comedy. But going into the comic book portions of this movie, what they do with the character, and again, the people in charge of the script and the source material and adapting it did a phenomenal job because they knew who this character is and the jokes and how to write for him, but also getting Ryan Reynolds in there as Deadpool. I mean, he is Deadpool. Like, now everyone knows he's been Deadpool for so long, they just didn't make a movie about him until now. And I think that his charismatic and quick one-liners and witty banter and just being a complete dick but sarcastic really sold this movie for myself, and it coming out on Valentine's Day, they did marketing, they knew what they had with this movie, and I think that this, again, set this tone where comic book movies, superhero movies, they can be more than just action. They can be funny, they can be heartwarming, there's more to these different genres, and I think actually this movie, moving forward, actually taught people that they can do that. They can almost stay in this realm of superhero comic book movies, but then bend it a bit into a different genre. So I think that this is a very pivotal movie to the overall comic book realm and genre, but also it is so f***ing hilarious. Again, I can't say f***ing. Okay, so this is a very funny movie. Getting into our top three, this is one that is very new. It just came out. It made $1 billion, and that is Joker. And I think that this had so many different things working for it. And the reason it's hitting in the top three is because it did something different. It's almost this grounded, in real life. There's no superpowers. There's no over-the-top CGI. This is very much a grounded film. And people are saying that it's the comparisons between Taxi Driver, The Comedian, King of Comedy. There's a lot of different inspiration in this movie, but I think that the overall things that really put this in the top three for myself, and I wanted to put it a little bit higher, but I think I need a little bit more time with it, maybe a rewatch or two. But Joaquin Phoenix's performance as the Joker and what they did with the character, really in a weird roundabout way, is it takes what you as an audience member, and you sympathize with this character, and honestly you can see why he becomes who he does at the end of the film. And there's so many different scenes that they do so well in this movie, and the tension and the buildup, and how this person isn't essentially evil. He's had one too many bad days, and then he isn't well, he's mentally ill, and he's dealing with all of these different problems, which I think them touching on mental illness and almost putting that in a perspective, in a light that the masses can hopefully digest and maybe understand it a bit, I loved it. I mean, it's got everything. Todd Phillips did a phenomenal job. So did Joaquin Phoenix. This is definitely one of the top three of the decade. Getting into the top two, this is again another comedy one that hit on my comedy list, and that is Scott Pilgrim versus the World. And this movie, again, I knew nothing about the comic. This movie I watched years later. I remember everyone saying, this is a great movie. This is one of my favorite movies of the decade. And I just had never seen it. And I sat down, and you do one of those things where you sit up and you're like, what is this? And this is a movie that almost I had never seen anything like it before. I had seen some of the Edgar Wright films prior to this, but this was something so different because it's very much this comic book movie, but video game and making it real life and playing with one-ups and health bars and all of these funny jokes. And when someone gets hit, we get the boom pow on the screen. And this is almost reminiscent of those old comic books that you see with the boom pow bubbles, but also playing into the real life aspects of a comic book in real life. All of these ridiculous monsters, swords, one-ups are happening in real life, and even all of the seven evil exes, all of the weird superpowers, but other people are kind of just like, oh, it's just a normal thing. And Edgar Wright's flavor and shooting style and overall just Edgar Wright-isms, I guess, in this movie work so well, and Michael Cera is phenomenal, and Marie Winstead, I can't think of her first name, but she is phenomenal and so beautiful. I'm sorry, I gotta say it, beautiful in this movie. So yeah, Scott Pilgrim versus the World, yes. But hitting at the number one spot, and everyone knows why, because this was one of my favorite movies last year, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, the animated movie Spider-Man. This movie is the definition of the perfect comic book movie. And some people are a little deterred because it's an animated movie, but they knew what they were doing in this movie. Not only does the animation it's groundbreaking, it's new, it's fresh, it's something that we hadn't seen before, but Lord and Miller putting their unique style and jokes, and how it's very much, it knows the Spider-Man character, it knows the Spider-Man character outside of this movie, and all of the different lore and different Spider-Man and Spider-People in this movie. Also focusing on not just Peter Parker, but bringing in, oh my gosh, I can't think of it. Ah. Wow, I just had a huge brain fart there. Miles Morales as a character, someone that has been in the comic books and the lore and even the video games, but we had never seen him on the big screen. That was a fresh take on the character because I personally was getting tired of Peter Parker, and I would love to see more in this world and all of the different Spider-Man and Gwen, Spider-Gwen and the Spider-Ham and Spider-Noir, everything, the voice cast in this movie, all of the different weird things that they do in this movie, and how this is probably going to make a huge franchise for Sony. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is the best comic book movie and one of the best movies of this decade. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. It is phenomenal. It does great things and it's very much self-aware, makes fun of the Spider-Man character and makes fun of itself. Anyways, those are my top 10 comic book movies of the decade, the 2010s. What did you guys think of my list? Was it the same as yours? A little bit different? Did I miss some heavy hitters on my list? Let me know what your guys' top 10 is in the comments down below. I'm really curious to see what exactly I might have missed. But yeah, anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Watch some more videos up there, you know, movie reviews, trailer actions, fun comedy skits. There's gonna be a couple more of these depending on how much time I have at the end of the year, but I know action, sci-fi, maybe even horror or musicals, I might touch on that. But stay tuned for all of these lists. Click that subscribe button, hit that like button, share this video out. Until next time though, I'll see you later.